Hey everybody, what's up? I got in the new Provident Metals 1 ounce silver Prospector round. This is their new release of the Prospector. It's a good design. Nice clouds there in the background with Doored Prospector on top. And here is the adventurous and fortune-seeking Prospector in the Sierra Nevada mountains with his trusty burro. There you can see the environment, grass and rocks, and he's wearing his boots. He's got his dishpan in his hand and he's holding a pickaxe. There's a river in the background there with some trees, with his trusty hat and his hairy growth from prospecting for such a long time. He's wearing suspenders. One interesting thing about the gold prospecting era is that the Levi company, the Levi Jean company, apparently Levi Strauss, actually went to California during the gold rush and was not able to find the fortune that he was looking for, but decided to make jeans out of the material that they were using for tents. And his jeans became very, very popular, and that is how the Levi Strauss company, a jean company, came into being. So anyway, very good round. On the reverse is the 1 troy ounce, 0.999 ounce fine silver inscription with the scene of a old western town. There's the saloon with some people coming out of the saloon. The motel or the hotel with the balcony. There's some people walking in the street, a woman carrying a satchel. There you can see the other buildings in the town. People wandering about on the wooden sidewalk. There's a man just having enjoyed the day. And there's a couple, well-dressed couple, with a dog, a man and his dog, walking across the street, the dust-covered street. So it's a decent-looking round. If these are minted here by Highland Mint. This is the original round, the original Prospector. Very good design. This one was a very well designed, and I bought a roll of 20, and all of these are starting to get milk spots, but you know, they're just bullion rounds. But this one was a very good design also. They also have one with the Colt 45 privy that's here and on this side here, and I never did get one of any of those. But the back of this was the most impressive part, I think, although the front was also impressive. But the back was just as impressive with the wooden table there in the background with the map and rope and the compass. Very detailed in the sexton. This is a very good design. I'm not sure if Highland minted these also, or if this was initially minted by Elemental Mint. I don't recall, but I do know that these, since Elemental definitely is no longer minting, that these are minted by the Highland Mint. Now these are not, some of these may be limited according to their website, but the Prospector round will continue in its series, I think, with new designs in the future, and also with maybe a limited amount of certain ones that they'll produce, such as the privy, the Colt 45 privy. So anyway, I like these. Reeded edge, not too rough around the edges, very well done. The brand new Provident Metals Prospector round. Also, I visited my local gold and silver dealer. and I picked up these generic rounds. This was before the silver prices started to go up, so I bought these a few weeks back. Nice round Indian head replica, nice edging around the inner ring, reeded edge, 1 troy ounce of silver with the laurel and the ribbons with the arrows with the American shield. Nice. And then a South Dakota round. I believe that this is 1987. I believe that High Hole Silver has a number of these. I just remember this seal, the Great Seal of South Dakota, depicting the agriculture, farming, and oil industries in the foreground, or in the design. It says, "Under God, the people." Rule. Under God, the people rule. That was not me burping. That was my water cooler. So anyway, and then I also picked up some Morgan dollars. I started a roll, 2 years ago. I just never filled it up. I've got 11 in here now because silver was getting so low, and the prices on these, when I first started buying silver, the value of these, the price for these, was reasonable, you know, melt value, and it was at my dealer. And then everybody started buying these, and they went up, and they just never went, it really went down. So no matter what the price of silver is or was, these tend to be over $22 for the nice ones, $25 to $32 for the real nice ones. And of course, those that have any kind of collectability, you know, they, as everyone knows, they can go up to, you know, $40, $50, $60, $80, $100 or so. Nothing special about these. These are all 1921. So there's three more to add to my stack. And since silver prices are going up, I may from time to time stop in and collect a few, buy a few more of these for to fill my roll up. So thanks for watching.